Namaste, dearly beloved, and welcome to your Foundations Flow, a beginner's vinyasa sequence for anyone who is seeking to get back to basics and their practice. So we'll come to our mat, and we will begin to warm up here by making some windmill motions with our arms, just circling the arms behind you one at a time, opening up the shoulders. Then begin to switch the directions, circling your arms forward. In this Foundations Flow class, and we're getting back to basics, so we'll be focusing primarily on Chaturanga cycles, Sun Salutations, which is the bread and the butter sequence within any yoga practice. Now begin to roll your shoulder blades back, feeling the chest open here. Really enjoying this delicious warm-up time. Then we'll step wide-legged and begin to knock on the door of life, making this twisting movement, this torsion moment. We'll slap the lower back with our hands as we just twist back and forth. Some moving meditation. I invite you to close your eyes as you do this. This warm-up awakens the main energetic channel of the spine, Sushumna Nadi, as it is called in Sanskrit, awakening the Kundalini serpent fire which lays dormant in the root of the spine. Continue to feel this powerful torsion movement, and now start to bring your hands up, tapping your shoulder points, the lung points, as you continue to twist from side to side. And I invite you to close your eyes as you do this and feel into your main energy channel. Beautiful movement here. And we'll start to release and bring the hands back down the lower back as you slowly come back to center, noticing the shifts already that you feel in your body. Inhale, stick out your hands, press them wide. Start to roll the wrist up and down as you extend. Inhale, roll, extend. Really feeling your energy field expanding outwards. We'll inhale, step to the top of the mat, Samasthiti, hands to heart center. Inhale, drop your hands. Exhale, bring them out to your sides. And then lift your limp wrist over your head, root to rise, tuck your tailbone forward. Press all four corners of the feet down. Exhale, forward fold, preparing for ragdoll pose. So grab opposite elbows. You can have your legs straight, or you can bend your knees, bringing your stomach towards your thighs, if that helps you go deeper into ragdoll. Focusing on the inhale, exhale, releasing any tension, any static energy that no longer serves you in the lower spine here. Ragdoll is a beautiful restorative posture to take always at the beginning of any sequence. Opening up the back here. This will allow us to fold deeper as we practice our sun salutations today, which will be the focus of this sequence. Inhale, look ahead of you, drop the hands down, and grab both of your big toes. Look ahead of you, straighten the legs, exhale, forward fold. Stick out your elbows as you continue to grab the toes here. Inhaling, exhaling. If you are at a point in your practice where this is too intense, again, I highly recommend to bend your knees during this forward fold. You can always bend your knees during forward fold in our sequence today versus having straight legs. Inhale, bend the knees for certain now, and we will transition back into a tabletop position. Right, this is a very important pose to warm up the spine as well. Your wrists are aligned with the knees. Inhale, look ahead of you, cow. Exhale, arch your back, cat. Inhale, look ahead of you, cow. Exhale, arch your back, cat. Inhale, cow. And really look up to the sky if you can. Exhale, cat. Arch your back. Maybe even lift up the palms of the hands. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. It's a beautiful warm up for the spine. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Inhale, neutral spine. Hey, this has been a beautiful warm up to align movement with the breath. One of the basic tenets of yoga. Every movement has an inhale or exhale. Now we're going to practice some yoga push-ups. So bring up your feet, balance on your knees, spread your fingers wide, exhale, chest down to the mat, inhale, come back up. Exhale down, chest to the mat, inhale, come back up. Exhale down, inhale back up. Exhale down, inhale back up. You can do it, queen. Yes, you can. Exhale down, inhale up. Feeling your core, your abdominals. Exhale down, and come on to your belly. These warm-ups are very important to practice in order to develop proper technique. So before we practice upward facing dog, let's practice cobra. Roll the shoulder blades back, lift up the chest from the mat, and this compresses the lower spine. You can start to twist the ankles in circular motion. Okay, bring our awareness to our feet. Okay, in cobra and upward facing dog, we press the backs of the feet down to the mat. So we're just releasing any tension here in the feet by, again, rotating the ankles in cobra. Release, press the backs of the feet down and come up a little bit higher in cobra. Exhale, third eye to the mat. Inhale, exhale. Just allowing yourself to feel the release in the back. And then inhale, push yourself back up into tabletop. And we'll take puppy pose here. So third eye to the mat. This is a variation of child's pose, which prepares us now for downward facing dog. Our bum is in the air as high as possible, like we just don't care. Okay? And we're using our hands to press the bum into the air here. And we're feeling that stomach to thigh contact. This is a very important pose to practice, right, in order to, again, find the proper alignment when we're in downward facing dog. Inhale, coming back up into tabletop. We'll bend our knees and we'll push ourselves back into a modified downward dog here. Again, the idea is to have the stomach to thigh contact. Fingers spread wide. We're slightly coming off the palms of the hands, pressing our bum into the air like we just don't care. And by having our knees bent, you want to remember that sensation as you then straighten your legs and start to bicycle. So just bicycle the heels here, pedaling. It's our first downward dog of the day. Downward dog, as you practice it over time, dearly beloved, will become more comfortable for you. Inhale, finding stillness. Exhale, tuck your chin towards your chest. Roll the shoulder blades in as if they're trying to touch, opening up the armpits. Heels come down towards the mat. Again, you should feel like your bum is awkwardly sticking up into the air. And That is actually the sensation you want to cultivate. Now inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, hop, jump, or float to top of the mat. Inhale, exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, root to rise. Inhale, limp wrists above our heads. Exhale, goalpost your arms. And then inhale, hands to heart center. Samastiti. Setting your intention for your practice now, we will embark on 10 sun salutations or chaturanga cycles. Inhale, hands to third eye. Exhale, bend your knees. Inhale, root to rise. Limp wrists over our head, raising our vibration. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, hop back. Inhale, into plank. Exhale, drop your knees, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Press those feet down. Roll the shoulder blades back, look up. Exhale, downward facing dog for one breath. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, hop, jump, or float. Inhale, exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, root to rise. Inhale, raise your hands to the heavens. Exhale, goalpost your arms. Inhale, hands to heart center, Samastiti. 9 more times at your own pace. You can do it, queen. During these 9 sun salutation cycles, I invite you to remember the breath. Unite every movement with an inhale or exhale. And for the adventurous queens, we can begin to cultivate ujjayi or victory breath, a heating breathing technique. Inhale through the nostrils, and with a closed mouth, exhale, moving the breath down the back of the throat. This pranayama breathing technique, again, helps us to build heat in the physical body, eliminating toxins and releasing any energies that no longer serve us. Beautiful. Keep going. You can do it. Salute the sun with divine grace. Gratitude is the cutest attitude. Yes, queen. some sun salutation tips for the curious queens. When you're beginning a sun salutation in mountain pose, Tadasana, you can bring your feet together, or you can have your feet slightly shoulder width distance apart. Tuck your tailbone forward and increase at the hips in forward fold, maintaining a flat lower back. In plank and downward facing dog, spread your fingers wide and push the palms down to the mat, creating some pressure. In upward facing dog as well, remember, we want to press the backs of the feet down and lift the knees slightly off the mat. And another tip for people in downward facing dog to find comfort in the pose, tuck your chin towards your chest. Same with forward folds. Always tuck your chin towards your chest. By focusing your awareness on aligning your breath with movement, we begin to develop tapas. And we begin to develop the ability to move with consciousness, to surrender to the flow. Just flow here, trusting the process. Right. It's a Namaste. Reconnecting with your breath before our 10th sun salutation. Inhale, bend your knees, raising our limp wrist above our head with gratitude, raising our vibration. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, hop back. Inhale, plank. And we're gonna hold it here. You don't want it, but we can. I know you can hold plank, activating your abdominals, activating your core, activating shoulders here. Press your heels back. Hold a little bit longer. Inhale. Exhale, drop your knees. Chaturanga. Slowly with divine grace. Inhale to upward facing dog. Beautiful. Exhale, downward facing dog. And we're going to hold here for 5 breaths. Inhale for 1. 2. 3. 4. Inhaling through your nostrils. Move the breath down the back of the throat. Close mouth. Exhale. Ujjayi victory breath for 5. Beautiful pranayama or breath work there. Inhale. Bend your knees. Touch your thighs to your stomach. Exhale, look ahead of you, hop, jump, or float to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Now exhale, grab your ankles, stick out your elbows, and fold deep here. Holding this variation of ragdoll, you can bend your knees if necessary. Inhale, deeply. Exhale, ujjayi. Move the exhalation on the back of the throat. Bend your knees. Inhale, root to rise. 1 burp at a time. Lifting our limp wrist above our head. Touching the heavens. Exhale. Meeting in prayer position. Namaste. Beautiful energetic work thus far. With these 10 sun salutations, reconnect with your breath, reconnect with your center, all 4 corners of your feet, uniting movement with breath, movement with consciousness. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, raise your limp wrist above your head. Now exhale, bend your knees, swoop forward, and prepare for Uttanasana, chair pose. Inhale and chair. As if you are sitting in a chair, bend your knees, raise your hands above your head, and sink down, activating the glutes, activating the thighs. Inhale, holding here. Exhale, ujjayi breath, and forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Hey, inhale. Kick back your left foot. Hold here. Look ahead of you. Inhale. Exhale. Raise your hands to prayer center for warrior 3. Finding your center here, your balance. Exhale down. Runner's lunge. Right side. Bending your knee in a 90 degree angle. Exhale back. Inhale, plank. Exhale, knees to the ground, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And slightly bend your knees if necessary here in dog, and to reestablish that stomach to thigh connection. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, hop, jump, or float to the top of the mat. Inhale, look up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Root to rise, 1 vertebra at a time. Exhale, bring your hands above your head. Inhale and exhale, goal post your arms. We meet in Samasthiti, hands to heart center. Yoking the divine here, merging matter with spirit. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, root to rise. Limp wrists above our head. Inhale, exhale, swoop forward. Bend your knees. Inhale, Uttanasana, chair pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And then kick back your right leg now. Inhale, look ahead of you. Square your hips. And slowly bring your hands up to prayer position, Samasthiti, when you feel you have found your center of gravity, your alignment, and warrior three, Virabhadrasana three. Exhale, down, runner's lunge, left side. Inhale, look ahead of you, bend that left knee, exhale, bring it back. Inhale into plank pose. Feeling your strength. Exhale, knees to the mat. Chaturanga. Inhale into upward facing dog. Lifting your knees off the mat. Exhale to downward facing dog for one breath. Inhale. Exhale, move the exhalation down the back of the throat. Bend your knees. Inhale, hop, jump, or float to the top of the mat. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, root to rise. Inhale, limp wrist above our heads. Touching the heavens. Exhale, goal post your arms. Samasthiti. Hands to heart center. Reconnect with your breath. Reconnect with your intention. Inhale, hands to third eye center. Exhale, drop your knees. Inhale, limp wrist above our head. Tuck your tailbone forward. Then inhale, look behind you, arch your back. Exhale, sweep forward. Inhale, chair. Pose, sink deeper into chair, exhale, forward fold, inhale, halfway lift, and then preparing here, kicking our left leg behind us again, square your hips, activate your glutes, abdominals, look ahead of you, curl the back left toes, exhale, down, align your heels, okay, back left foot is bent, slightly 45 degrees, coming into Superman. Okay. Chest and stomach to our right thigh here. Spreading the hands behind you. Inhale, interlace your fingers behind you. Exhale, coming up into warrior one. Focus on squaring your torso ahead of you. Inhale, exhale, coming into runner's lunge. Inhale, exhale, coming into plank pose. Inhale, exhale, knees down. Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, exhale. Reconnecting with your Ujjayi breath here. Inhale. Exhale, bend your knees. Hop, jump, or float, top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, root to rise, one vertebra at a time. Inhale, limp wrist above our head. Exhale, goal post your arms. Samasthiti, hands to heart center. Tuck your tailbone forward, reconnect with your breath. Inhale, hands to third eye. Exhale, bend your knees. Inhale, root to rise, limp wrist above our head. Look behind you, arch your back. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, chair pose, bend those knees. Sink a little bit deeper this time. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. We're going to inhale, kick up our right leg behind us, square our hips. Okay. Feeling your abdominals, your core activated here. Exhale, drop that back right foot. Align your right and left heels. Back right foot is bent slightly, 45 degree angle. Inhale, Superman. Feeling your core here as we touch our stomach and chest to our left thigh. Hands behind us. We're flying like Superman Queen. Beautiful. Interlace your fingers. Now coming up into Warrior One. Virabhadrasana. Inhale. Lift your limp wrist above your head. Goalpost your arms. Exhale. Runner's lunge. Left side. Inhale. Look ahead of you. Exhale. Bring that left foot back. Inhale into plank pose. You can do it. Feeling your power. Exhale. Knees to the mat. Chaturanga. Inhale. Upward facing dog. Looking to the heavens. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Beautiful work here. Reconnect with your breath. Remember to push those heels towards the earth. Inhale. Exhale. Bend those knees. Look ahead of you. Exhale. Hop, jump, or float to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, root to rise, one vertebra at a time. Inhale, limp wrist above our head, touching the heavens. Exhale, goalpost your arms. We meet with hands and heart center. Prayer position, Samastiti. Reconnecting with your breath, feeling the shifts already in your subtle and physical body. We will prepare to practice now Warrior 3 and 2. We'll be transitioning from Warrior 3 to Warrior 2. So some balancing poses. So feel grounded in all four corners of your feet. Inhale, hands to third eye. Exhale, bend your knees. Inhale, root to rise, limp wrist above our head. Tuck your tailbone forward. Feel that line of energy. Exhale, goal post your arms, and then interlace your fingers behind you. So this helps us square our hips and is really important to practice when you are beginning the warrior poses. Now, preparing for warrior three, inhale, lift up your left foot, extend it forward, and then bring it back, coming to balance on your right leg. Curl the back left toes. Activate your glutes, activate your core. Inhale, exhale down, coming up into Warrior One, maintaining fingers interlaced behind you. Square those hips. Inhale, opening up into Warrior Two. So the back foot is bent at 90 degrees. Right and left heels are aligned. Your torso is facing the side, okay? So as you bend the front knee 90 degrees and then straighten, okay, we want to practice this technique where our head is what is twisting forward, not our torso. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. Look over that front right hand. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. And hold here, finding your power, cupping the ground, drawing up Mother Earth energy through our feet, feeling your power here in Warrior Two. Inhale, straighten. And then we're gonna prepare now for triangle pose, okay? So the front leg is straight, and we're gonna bring down the right hand outside the right foot, or you can grab, okay, the right shin, And we're going to inhale as we lift up our left hand. Our drishti, or gazing point, is our left palm as we stack the shoulders here. Okay. Gazing towards the left palm for triangle. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Coming back forward. Third eye to knee. Bending that right knee for runner's lunge. Inhale. Look ahead of you. Exhale. Bring the knee back. And then inhale. We meet in plank pose. Exhale. Knees to the mat. Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. Breathing here, reconnecting with your ujjayi breath. Tuck your chin towards your chest. Roll the shoulder blades back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Bend your knees. Exhale. Prepare to hop, jump, or float to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Exhale, root to rise, one vertebra at a time. Inhale, our limp wrist above our head, touching the heavens. Exhale, goalpost your arms. We meet in prayer position, Samastiti. Reconnecting with your breath, preparing now for the same sequence on the opposite side. At your own pace, you can do it. I will let you do this without instruction. To have your own experience, it is your body, your practice. Good luck, all my rainbow warriors of peace. You can do it. wherever you are in the cycle, we will meet in downward facing dog for a few breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Observing the differences in your downward dog at this stage in the practice versus the beginning, bend your knees. Look ahead of you. Exhale, hop, jump, or float to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Then we're going to, on the forward fold, exhale, grab our ankles, stick out our elbows, and fold deeper here. For one, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. If you need, you can bend your knees as well to encourage that stomach to thigh contact. Now we're going to inhale, bend our knees. Exhale, root to rise very slowly, no rush, one vertebra at a time. Inhale, limp wrist above our head, touching the heavens. Exhale, goalpost your arms. We meet in prayer position. Namaste. You've done so much beautiful energetic work, Queen. It is now time to begin to wind down this sequence, to wind down this foundation's flow. So reconnect with your breath here. Sending your breath wherever it needs to go. Observing the shifts, observing the difference in how you feel now versus the start of practice. Breathe easy here, in and out, extending the belly on the exhalation, contracting the belly on the inhalation. And moving the breath, sending it wherever it needs to go to do its healing work. Inhale, hands to third eye. Exhale, bend your knees. Inhale, root to rise, limp wrist above our head. Tuck your tailbone forward. Spread your fingers wide. Hold here. Feeling that straight line of energy from the crown down to the root. Hold here. Inhale. Open mouth, exhale. This is deep cleansing work. You can do it. Keep holding. Inhale. Beautiful. Slowly releasing the hands down. Exhale, forward, fold. Inhale, halfway lift, look ahead of you. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees, and we'll come back into a tabletop position. Knees and hands are aligned. Inhale, neutral spine. Look ahead of you. Exhale, cat, arch your back. Inhale, cow, look ahead of you. Exhale, cat, arch your back. Inhale, cow, look ahead of you. Exhale, cat, arch your back. Inhale, cow, look ahead of you. Exhale, cat, arch your back. Maybe even come slightly off the palms. Inhale, cow, look ahead of you. Exhale, cat, arch your back. Inhale, cow. Neutral spine. And we're going to slowly bring our chest down and then come onto our stomach. We're going to interlace our fingers behind us for modified baby cobra. So this is a beautiful pose to activate the glutes, pressing the feet down. Okay, stretching the shoulders, the chest lifts up off the ground. Inhale, exhale, release your hands, and then bring your third eye to the mat. Bring up your knees, and then push yourself slowly back into puppy pose, just like at the beginning of practice. Again, noticing the differences in this expression of puppy than when we first started the practice. Okay, all my beautiful rainbow warriors of peace, it is time to transition to our next asana, our next pose. Thread the needle. Inhale, lift up your left hand. Exhale, thread it through. You can extend the right arm straight. Okay, and so we're getting a nice shoulder stretch here with thread the needle. Palm of the left hand is facing up. So the back of the right shoulder and tricep is creating pressure on the mat, on the earth. Thread the needle is a wonderful pose to cleanse the heart meridian or nadi lines of subtle energy that begin in the palms of the hand and travel all the way to the inner armpits. So just breathe easy here in and out of your open mouth. Enjoying this delicious thread the needle pose. If you desire deeper sensation and thread the needle, a variation you can take is to take your extended right hand and wrap it behind your back. Okay, all my beautiful rainbow warriors of peace, slowly, wherever you are, start to transition out of thread the needle. Bring the left hand back up to the sky. Maybe make some circles, windmilling that left arm, releasing any energy that no longer serves you. And we prepare for thread the needle on the opposite side. inhale, just do a few cat-cows here. Again, preparing for thread the needle. And when you are ready, lift up that right hand, gazing to the sky. Inhale, exhale, thread the needle, bringing the right shoulder and tricep to the earth. You can extend, again, the left hand straight, left palm down, right palm up. Explore whatever variation feels comfortable as we cleanse the heart meridian or nadi channels. Enjoy thread the needle, one of my favorite restorative postures. Dearly beloved, it is time to release, thread the needle, cultivate the intention to slowly move and bring that right palm to the sky. Maybe give that right arm some circles, just releasing any energy that no longer serves you. Then we will meet in tabletop. Inhale. Exhale, push yourself back, sitting on your heels, and then slowly come forward, third eye to the mat, child's pose. So in this restorative posture, okay, your fingers are spread wide, and we're using the palms to push the bum towards our heels. Over time, as you begin to practice child's pose, the bum should rest on your heels. Child's pose is one of the most powerful restorative postures that one can cultivate in their practice. It activates all of the energy lines or meridians in the body. It, again, is so powerful to practice child's pose. If you have only 5 minutes per day to devote to your practice, child's pose is the pose for you, boo. Enjoy breathing in and out of our open mouth. No thought to the breath here. Be easy, queen. Slowly, when you are ready, look ahead of you and cultivate the intention to move. Come back onto our heels first. Hero's pose, and then slowly bring your feet out from underneath you, extend your legs wide, lift up one sit bone and then the other, and inhale, limp wrist above our head, exhale, forward fold, grab your feet, and in this forward fold, the seated forward fold, the intention is to maintain a nice flat back and crease forward at the hips. So, just like in our downward facing dog, just like we've been practicing throughout this foundation's flow, the goal is to bring your stomach and chest towards the thighs. Wherever you are, inhale, look ahead of you. Exhale, slowly come back up, one vertebra at a time, no rush. Bend your knees, hop to the top of the mat, and then one vertebra at a time, come back. Okay. Modified bridge pose. Walk your feet as close as possible to your bum. Knees are bent. And start to do some mini cat-cows on the mat here. Just slowly lifting up the pelvis, just ever so slightly from the mat. The mini cat-cows here, preparing the lower spine for our final resting pose. Do as many as you feel is necessary. Inhale, lift the hands back up by your sides. And then we're going to interlace our fingers and come into modified bridge. Okay, pressing the shoulder blades down, lift up the lower body. This is a beautiful pose to give some slight compression to the lower lumbar spine. Okay, you're pressing the heels down, activating the glutes, activating the thighs here. And you want to imagine that your thighs are opening up and out. When you're ready, you can release this pose. And then bring your knees towards your chest. Touch your forehead, third eye to your knees. Inhale. Hold the exhale for 1, 2, 3. And release it all into Shavasana, corpse pose, our final resting pose. You did it, queen. You earned it. Now is the time to rest, relax, and allow yourself to absorb all the energetic benefits of your practice. Stay in Shavasana as long as you need. Recommended 5 to 10 minutes. If you only have 3 minutes, that is fine. But again, stay here as long as you need and observe the shifts. Observe the sensations, observe the elevated energy you have cultivated just by what movement. Giving thanks to your body for being healthy and able to practice the sacred science of yoga today. Giving thanks to yourself for carving out this time and space for your own wellness. Thank you so much for joining us today. Again, my name is Trey. This channel is Experiential Energy Anatomy. With gratitude, the light within me honors the light within you. Namaste. And as always, I encourage those who practice yoga to become aware of how to decolonize yoga. How can you give thanks to the elevated ancestors from the ancient cultures such as India, from which this sacred science comes from? Educate yourself about the lived realities of people in these countries. And thank you again so much for joining us today, practicing yoga at home with Experiential Energy Anatomy. Every single comment, share, like, save, and subscribe is truly appreciated from the bottom of my heart chakra to yours in order to continue to grow this channel organically and continue to offer to the introverts these online free yoga classes. My intention, as always, is to get all those who are interested in practicing yoga more in touch with the roots from which, again, this sacred science comes from. So I hope you enjoyed this Foundations Flow class. May you flow with divine grace in your life. Namaste. Toodaloo.